Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at new iCloud storage options in macOS Sierra. So let's take a look at how in macOS Sierra it's expanded how you can use iCloud Drive to include the documents and desktop folders, and you have lots of different options for managing your files. This is particularly useful for someone on a MacBook and you have limited hard drive space, but you may have a lot of files. So if you go into System Preferences and you look under iCloud, you'll see that you've got the option now to add desktop and documents to your iCloud Drive. So here under iCloud Drive, I have that turned on, and previously that would just give me an iCloud Drive folder, which then of course is synced across all my devices. But now under Options, I can go in and I can turn on desktop and documents and folders. And when I do that, what happens is the desktop and documents folder move. Now actually, if you look here in the Finder, you can see under Favorites, my desktop and documents folder have actually moved under iCloud next to iCloud Drive. So instead of being folders under iCloud Drive, they're actually just separate onto themselves, but they're also in here, so you have two different ways to get to them. My documents folders, just like it was before, it actually moves everything automatically. And of course, since I don't have very many files, they're all here on my local Mac. So what this is actually doing, it's very similar to if you use Dropbox in the past. It actually syncs all these files to iCloud, and then any other Macs I have that have this turned on, their documents folders would look identical to this one. And anything I changed on one Mac would then change on the other. So I have one documents folder for all my Macs. Now, does this mean you have to choose all or nothing, either everything's in iCloud or nothing's in iCloud? Well, not really, because the desktop and documents folders are special folders that you could do this with. However, you can create other folders in your home folder here, and I've actually created a Documents 2 folder, and that's not going to be stored in iCloud Drive. And other things like, say, my Movies folder is not going to be there either. So if I'm working on videos and they're stored in the Movies folder, then they would just be in the local drive and not take up iCloud Drive space. So you have the option there, if you use Desktop and Documents in iCloud, to still store stuff completely locally, and then use Documents and Desktop to be your cloud storage. Or you cannot have this option turned on at all, and your Documents and Desktop folders are local, but you still have the iCloud Drive folder, which would have stuff stored in iCloud. So you have several different ways to handle this, depending upon how much you want to use iCloud. Now, this is definitely not for everybody. A lot of people like to have complete control over where their files are at all times. Other people may be in situations where they don't have a great internet connectivity. But for those of us who have high-speed internet all the time, are used to using cloud services like Dropbox, and have been using iCloud Drive since it came out, this is a great option, because not only would Documents and Desktop be synced between our Macs, but it'll be in the cloud as well. So it'll be more secure in that we won't be as susceptible to things like hard drive failures or getting a laptop stolen and things like that. Another benefit of using this, of course, is that iCloud Drive is available in iOS. So you could be on your iPad and you can go into your iCloud Drive folder, and there's Desktop and Documents. And you don't have to think about it. You can simply go into it, and there are all your desktop files, there are your documents files, whereas other cloud solutions, you may have to make sure you put that file in the cloud drive before you know you need it later on when you're actually out of the office or away from home.